Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to the Zoo Tycoon Diaries, the Challenge Zoo. It is me, Ruffy993, and hopefully in this episode, we can finally wrap up this thing. Because, as we can see, which one is it? It's this button. And this button, and then this button. We need two more game challenges in order to get the safari-themed buildings and objects, which, in my opinion, is like one of my favorite themed buildings. And I do also realize that if I had succeeded in these two challenges, as well as accepted the African Jeep challenge that was presented to us quite a few episodes ago, I might be that much closer and we might be done with this. But instead, I did not, so here we are. Now, what I do plan on doing is, oh my gosh, the jaguars. Do I have any jaguars left? I have one. H, you are female. Do I have any jaguars? No. Oh, I have another jaguar there. That's probably a sibling. It's male. Yeah, they're siblings. They can all stay in there. They'll be fine for now. Because in case I need to adopt a certain animal species in order to get these game challenges done, it might be time to replace some of these old exhibits and replace them with newer animals that would be more exciting to our guests. Anyways, what I am going to do is I'm just going to wait until we're presented with a game challenge, not a photo challenge, not an endangered species challenge, but indeed a game challenge. So I'll just meet you guys when that happens. Oh, scholar's achievement. What was that one for? Oh, you received 25 grand in educational donations. Nice. Ooh, okay. A game challenge. A private benefactor has approached your zoo and would like to make an anonymous transaction. They have an animal available, but they refuse to disclose what species. They've implied that it's a rare species, but won't provide a guarantee. They do guarantee that it is a legal transaction. They are offering the animal to you for the cost of 16 grand. And should you accept, your crated animal will be delivered near the area near the front gate. Well, it's kind of sketchy sounding, but we do have 16 grand. It's a simple challenge. We'll accept it. Oh, unfortunately, the anonymous benefactor did not accurately represent the facts. While you have received a healthy animal, it is not as exclusive as it was implied, and it's likely that you have been overpaid. However, the animal is certainly better off in your care than the hands of this unscrupulous benefactor, and your guests will certainly enjoy the new addition. Okay, so they screwed us out of our money. I wonder what they gave us. Where's the entrance of my zoo? What'd they give us? A ring-tailed lemur. Yeah, they could have given us better, but a ring-tailed lemur isn't too bad. And actually, I believe on my animal adoption list, we can get it a mate too. So it definitely will be happier. Is it like the tire swing? Oh, it doesn't. I was going to say, maybe we can put our tire swing to good use. Oh, well. That's not so bad. Let's give it the cool new endangered species themed buildings here. Again, we're gonna put this right where the tundra fountain is, but whatever, it's fine, it's cool. And it's because it's, actually, lemurs don't require a whole bunch of space. Actually, I'm gonna replace that with that. I like having the fences between my exhibits to be a solid fence, and then, like, the guest-only fences to be with glass or, you know, low enough for the people to see over them. I'm not entirely sure why I have that sort of, oh, where'd my lemur go? Did I leave him way over there at the back? Did I not drag him over? Lemur. Oh, yeah, he's still there. It's a male lemur. But yeah, I don't believe lemurs need a whole bunch of space. There's some that don't. Like, any herd animal, like bison or Thompson's gazelles. Actually, a lot of the savanna-type animals do not require a whole bunch of space because, you know, they live in an environment naturally where space isn't kind of hard to come by. You basically live in crowded conditions the entire time. So I think a little bit smaller exhibit for this guy isn't so bad. Let's give him the substrate pile with apples. I love these piles. They have, like, substrate piles, the logs, the more entertaining versus just, like, food laying on the ground, but more enriching kind of food displays. I really like using for my freeform zooms where I just go all out and make, like, the best soup possible. Here we go. Exhibit and a mate for you. Oh, wonderful. Oh, wait, is it a photo challenge? Oh, it's a photo challenge. I hate that. It says game challenge, but as soon as he photographs, You know it's not right, but Children's Reader Magazine is having a contest for the best animal photographs of the year. If you can get photos of giant pandas, red pandas, and beavers engaged in specific behaviors, you'll win the coveted Children's Reader Photo Award. Winning this award will make your child guests much happier with your zoo for a period of time. Difficulty challenging. Again, sorry. I want a game challenge, not a photo challenge. Another one. Albistro Magazine wants a unique angle for an upcoming issue and would like to feature photographs of animals eating from interesting containers. They've requested photographs of a cheetah, a reticulated giraffe, and a ringtail lemur eating from specific food containers and will pay you $2,000 per photo. I want a game challenge, not a photo challenge, please. What do they want to do here between while waiting for a challenge to crop up? Is I'm going to release my jaguars into the wild. And I'm going to actually replace this exhibit with a snow leopard exhibit. Because, you know, we got more alpine stuff on this side. So we'll make ourselves another alpine exhibit. Let's see here. I thought there was 3 jaguars in here. I know there is. Is it in there? Yeah, there he is. Alright, release them all into the wild. Propagate in the wild. If only it was so easy. There are some introduction into the wild programs that work really well. I think for endangered species or, you know, vulnerable, the mandrill, which is an animal you can adopt in this game, I think has like a really high success rate for introductions into the wild. And they do pretty well, but sometimes it's kind of hit and miss. Depends on the species, too. Depends how much, you know, human care is required in raising them as well. That's the thing. You want them to release them into the wild, but you still want them to be fearful of humans, which can sometimes be difficult to do. I know our local zoo has a little section where they take in fawns that, you know, people have found on the side of the roads where their mothers have been hit. And I think last time we went there, they probably had 8 of these fawns, white-tailed deer and mule deer, that they had in rehabilitation centers blocked away from prying eyes. There's like one little area where you can look at them, but you're supposed to be like quiet, not say anything, so that they're still wary around humans. And I believe they actually have they have it set up so there's like even the people, like the keepers who feed them, have to bottle feed them, there's still minimal interaction between those that have to bottle feed some of the younger ones so that they still have that wariness around people, which is good. I really like that. Some of the other animals at their zoo. Oh, what's this? Oh, more benefactors, eh? But just before I read this, some of the other animals at their zoo, they, I think they're 2 grizzly bears passed away of old age. They were old grizzly bears. And the 2 new ones they have were actually from a cub rescue center somewhere in northern BC or the Yukon, I believe. But yeah, those guys weren't able to be reintroduced into the wild, so they have these year, I think they're about a year old now, that they've raised now, and they're the new grizzly bears at the zoo. They have cute names, I don't remember what they're called. But yes, our private benefactor has approached your zoo and would like to be able to make an anonymous transaction. They have an animal available, but they refuse to disclose what species. They've implied it is a rare species, but won't provide a guarantee. They do guarantee that this is a legal transaction. They're offering the animal to you for the cost of $16,000 again. Is this the same private benefactor that duped us over the last time? If we were smart people, we wouldn't accept it, but I want these safari-themed buildings, so I will accept the challenge. Did they screw us over? Unfortunately, yes. The anonymous benefactor did not accurately represent the facts. Okay, so it was an animal not worth. What were the lemurs worth, out of curiosity? Do I still have the lemurs? I think lemurs were worth maybe $10,000. I'm not exactly sure. It might be 10 that a lemur's worth. Or maybe 7. Yes! Oh my gosh, yay! Game challenges reward! We got it! We got all of the challenge game stuff that we can get. All those themed buildings. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Congratulations, you've unlocked the safari themed buildings and objects. Oh my gosh, this is going to be like a short episode, but because those 2 game challenges were really short, let's be honest. But they got a Bengal tiger. Wow, that's actually not bad. I actually kind of want to replace this exhibit and to make it a rainforest one again. I will. We'll put that guy in an exhibit before we end off the episode. That's not bad because the Bengal tiger's worth 15,000 to adopt. So, eh, it could have been better, I suppose. But let's get some leopards in there. Snow leopards. I love snow leopards. They're pretty. They're floofy. I like floofy things. There, have a feeder ball. Have a scratching post. There's a thing for you to play with. All right, and our Bengal tiger. So, is there any space left in the zoo? Anywhere. We can stick it right here at the end. It's not going to play with that. I know that. But we can wrap up the zoo by. Let's see here. Let's just do. We'll do that. That will be our Bengal tiger exhibit. Actually, I also realized whenever I build my rainforest exhibits, I may have been doing them wrong. Rainforest exhibits, well, rainforests in general, have very thick cover. And so placing like trees sparsely here and there, is kind of good, but realistically, they're all really, really close together and hardly anything grows underneath them. So realistically, something like this is more likely how an actual canopy would make. Oh my gosh, they're giving us more challenges. Well, actually, we're done. We can do one more. We'll do one more challenge just for the fun of it. This is an easy one. The marketing department is preparing a zoo brochure and has requested the pictures of the following: guests holding an ice cold soda and a guest sitting on a bench. Providing these pictures will help improve your zoo's fame as flyers promoting your zoo. It will begin to circulate around your community. Difficulty, easy. Okay, look at all the photo challenges. I do like photo challenges. Some of them can be like really long and tedious. Because you have to wait for, like, babies to be made or them doing certain things. Oh, there's a Bengal tiger. They're beautiful. Actually, Bengal tigers, in my opinion, are one of the species that, with the transition from the first Zoo Tycoon to the second Zoo Tycoon graphics, I kind of think they look a little funny. I don't know. Like, their feet just seem huge. And their faces kind of, I question their faces. But I don't know, it's still cool looking. It's still an improvement from the first Zoo Tycoon, but there are some animals that I think got really botched in the process of transitioning them from how they looked in the first Zoo Tycoon to the second Zoo Tycoon. And I have no idea how they look on the Xbox version. But here, I'll give you some gates, zookeeper, so you can do your job. I think personally the grizzly bears look stupid in this game. Like, their faces just look messed up. The wolves too, which I think I do have in this exhibit. Where are the wolves? Their faces kind of look weird. They don't have like a pointed nose. They kind of have a like a droopy rounded off nose, and their faces just look derpy. Like, can you tell me that you've seen a wolf, like TV pictures, that looks like that? None of them. But granted, there are some animals that look pretty fantastic, like markhors. The giraffes look super cool. There's poop everywhere in this exhibit. Oh my gosh. But yeah, I definitely think that this game, graphic-wise, really knocked out of the park for a lot of the herbivores and just the way that they look. They're pretty cool. But yeah, some of the predatory species, they're a little sketchy looking, in my opinion. They were a little weird. Anyways, what were we doing? We have to take a picture of a guest sitting on a bench and one drinking an ice cold soda. Well, surely we can do that. That guy has a water bottle. The soda stand is over there. Anybody want soda? Let's see. Let's just find somebody with a drinking problem, a drinking problem, a drinking need, mind you. This person, what do you have in your hand? Oh, you have a water. You're lame. People, aren't any of you thirsty? No, don't look at the insect, huh? Buy yourself an ice cold soda. Understand? I need a kid. Kids are the ones who like soda. Let's see here. Are you a kid? You are not a kid. Are you a kid? You are not a kid. You're a kid. Have an ice cold soda, kid. Oh, our lions are dying. Oops. Have a soda. Yeah! Let's snap a photo. Probably get the permission. Guest? Well, no, I'm the manager of the zoo. I can choose what I want to do. Oh. Ah, ice cold soda. He doesn't bring it to his lips with the straw, though. He just, starts drinking at it from wherever. Ah, that guest is getting up. Never mind. That's a maintenance worker. I need a guest on a bench. I got benches everywhere. People are dancing, having a grand old time. There's a guest on a bench. Hello. Oh, sir! Sir, I want to take your picture. All right. Anybody else want to sit on a bench? Oh, thank you. On a bench. Perfect. Perfect.